And on the Busch Grand National short track so far this season has been Chuck Bound, but a different story down in Barberville, Florida.
Yeah, Chuck had won four short track races in a row, but Tommy Houston put an end to that. For highlights of the Firecracker 200, here's Tommy Kirkman.
After a short rain delay, Chuck Bound led the field to the green. Tommy Houston got by Bound for the lead, but several cars never turned a full lap. Dave Mader, Rick Mask, Bobby Labonte, L.D. Ottinger, Kenny Wallace, and Davey Johnson were involved. Mast, Mader, and Johnson called it a night. Bobby Labonte's crew worked furiously on his car, and with the help of Jimmy Hensley's and Chuck Bound's crews, lost only 16 laps before returning. When racing resumed, Houston and Chuck Bound battled for the lead, while the third-place car of Dana Patton slid completely off course. Jeff Burton followed with a spin of his own, and when the action heated up again, it was Houston and Tommy Ellis up front. But then the barrage of yellow began. Burton spun again, and then Billy Standridge, and Dana Patton once more. Ward Burton, Jack Sprague, and Jimmy Hensley wrecked in slippery turn four, and more speedy dry was put down, and the track kept getting slicker. Steve Grissom spun on the backstretch, and then Robert Presley lost it to bring out the eighth caution by lap 80. Several laps later, Tommy Ellis cut down a tire and lost his second spot to hard-charging Bobby Hamilton. Just past halfway, Cecil Yunus spun, and he was followed by Randy Porter. On lap 115, the lap car of Tommy Ellis pushed Houston up the track, and Hamilton slipped by. His lead was interrupted by a skirmish involving Dana Patton and Billy Standridge. Standridge, Jack Sprague, and Gary Neese brought out caution number 13, and several laps later, L.D. Ottinger, Donnell Burkhalter, and the sixth-place car of Tom Peck piled up. After both wrecks, you guessed it, more speedy drive. By now, Volusia County Speedway looked more like Daytona Beach, complete with a dune buggy. The race was red flagged on lap 162 to clean up the mess. When the race restarted, it didn't take Tommy Houston long to get by Hamilton. Patty Moise brought out caution number 15 and then teamed up with Jimmy Hensley for the 16th and final caution of what was beginning to be a long night. With 11 laps of racing left, Bobby Hamilton and Elton Sawyer battled for second, but no one could catch Tommy Houston as he picked up his third win of 1990.
Steve, it's time now for the mailbox, and our first question comes from Mrs. Ronald Beckman of New Britain.